Good day everyone, and welcome back to Jagged Alliance 2. Now you may notice that things are a little bit quieter than what they were last time. That's because it turns out the music in this game is protected by copyright. I got a content ID notification when I uploaded the last episode. Shouldn't be something that affects my channel, but just in case to avoid any potential copyright shenanigans, I've decided to mute the music from now on, which is a bit of a shame. I think this game has some great tracks to it. I'm already starting to get a little bit weirded out because of all this quiet. So used to having the music on all the time. But anyway, in the last episode, actually one correction, or rather addition, is necessary from last episode, where I showed the doctor and patient tasks that you can assign to your mercenaries. Now in that there I showed that I put Ira as a doctor and Bunce as a patient in order to heal her, but I forgot to mention that doctors can also heal themselves. So now that Bunce is injured and she has a medkit, I can just set her to doctor and she starts healing herself. So it's not always necessary to have two people in order to do doctoring, like two separate people where one is a doctor and the other is a patient. Doctors can also heal themselves, assuming they have the skill and a medkit available. So last time we did the first battle in Omerta and we met the rebels led by Miguel, who instantly gave us a task to head to Drassen and secure a food supply route for the rebels. So Drassen is going to be our first target for an offensive. So let's start heading towards Drassen. Now in order to move our mercenaries, there are two ways you can go about it. The one that I like to use is I click the sector where the mercenaries we want to move are. Then we can choose to either move individual mercs or an entire squad at once. And then we can just start moving in the map. Now in order to move, mercenaries need to be assigned to a squad first. Being assigned to a squad means that they're essentially idling and are ready to move out. If they're assigned to a task, they can't be moved. Now despite the fact that Drassen is our target, we don't want to set Drassen directly as our first target. Instead, we'll want to set a sector adjacent to Drassen. This is because moving around the strategy map or doing various tasks like doctoring or repairing expends our character's energy, but not in the same way that we saw in the last episode, where as Barry was exploring the sector, his energy level started depleting rapidly but also restored very quickly as well. Doing tasks or moving in the strategy map expends your character's maximum energy. I'll demonstrate it in practice. If I set Bunce as a doctor and start compressing time, we can see as she's doing the task, her maximum energy level, the blue bar, starts going down. Now what this means in practice is that her maximum energy in a combat situation is only 76, and this can have a significant effect on her combat performance depending on how tired she is. In order to restore this lost maximum energy, we can set our character to sleep and then start compressing time again. That will rest them up. Maximum energy starts restoring very quickly. So what this means is that we'll want to first travel to a sector that's next to Drassen, rest for a minute to make sure our energy levels are as high as possible, and only then attack Drassen. Anything else that I would like to mention before we head out? Well, it's very likely that we'll run into a random enemy patrol somewhere before we hit Drassen, so a fight is very likely. If I can, I would like to try to avoid these patrols, but it may be difficult, so we best get ready for a fight. Understand.
Enemies have been detected in this area.
Yeah, here we are. That didn't take too long. When it comes to these random patrols, we don't have to fight them manually. We also have the choice of auto-resolve. That is an extremely bad idea. It will likely result in taking serious injuries, and in worst cases it will result to a full squad wipe. Alright, so we will be encountering these enemies in very open and difficult terrain to fight in, and to make matters worse, it would be during the daytime. I find that fighting in open terrain like this with short-range weapons as we have now is very ineffective. So what I want to try and do is attempt to quietly slip from one end of the sector to the other, and then we can retreat from the fight and proceed to the next sector, luckily without encountering any enemies. I prefer to think that this early on in the game were gorillas who don't engage unnecessary targets in unfavorable odds. The practical reason why I do this is because I want to avoid as many possibilities of taking damage as I can. Fights in open terrain like this with short-range weapons can really go both ways, and since both us and our enemies are firing out of effective range, it often comes down to luck who gets the first hit. Open terrain like this where cover is very spread out means that making any sort of flanking moves also have their own risks, particularly when the enemies outnumber us, like they do in this case. So let's just realize that discretion is the better part of valor and slip out and engage a more useful target. Alright, we made it to the other end safely, but that's not the end of it. There's a very good chance that this patrol is going to start chasing us. They do notice that we are around, so we may need to fight them regardless, but let's see if we can make some better.
Got where I needed to be. What's on the agenda?
They moved in the opposite direction, but it's quite likely that they're patrolling this stretch of road here, which means they can loop straight back very soon. So we may not be able to rest here in peace. Let's take this moment to explore this sector. It's always worth to check any sectors that have buildings in them. Luckily the locals don't mind us taking their hard-earned items. Perhaps it's because they're sympathetic to a rebel cause and willing to donate whatever we can use. There are exceptions to this rule, however. Named NPCs in particular can have items that they consider their owned items, and they won't allow us to take them. If they do see us take them, in some cases they express their disappointment with words and a reduced down loyalty, and in other cases they express it with bullets, depending on the NPC. So always be careful, and if you're on, you can tell in the sector inventory whether an item is owned, if it's grayed out, but would be otherwise accessible. But I'm sure we'll get to talk about that more when it becomes relevant. I don't need another crowbar.
Understand.
It's unlikely that I'll ever use this one crowbar in any case. We don't need more than one. Yeah, as you can see, the locals are perfectly okay with us raiding their fridge and leaving it open. Even unnamed NPCs like this can have some useful dialogue sometimes. They can give tips related to quests and locations around Urulko. It's always worth to go through the dialogue, even random from generic unnamed NPCs, until the dialogue starts looping. Once it starts looping, you know that
got it.
They don't have anything more useful to say. These generic NPCs outside of towns rarely have anything. Typically they only loop their generic responses. Here is our first locked door that we've encountered. Now we have several options how to try to bust this one open. We can either try to use brute force by kicking it, or using a crowbar, which is dependent on strength, or then we can also try to lockpick it, which requires that the character has a locksmith kit in their inventory, and then the actual lockpicking skill takes into account the character's dexterity, mechanical skill, and possibly the locksmithing specialization, assuming they have it. So Barry is our lockpick guy, so he should have a decent to high chance of lockpicking this.
Terrible.
If you don't succeed at once, just keep trying again.
Groovy.
If the lock is too difficult for the character skill level to handle, they will eventually give a piece of dialogue saying that they can't do it.
Okay.
Right. So that's it for these buildings. We found a bit of cash, but a very measly amount. Alright, so now that... There is a good chance that this patrol is going to loop back here. We could try to perhaps maneuver around. But it's also very likely that there's another patrol here in the north as well. So we may just be the easiest to wait around and fight the patrol like normal. Let's just get into better positions first where we are better equipped to intercept them. Now this environment is much better suited to fighting with short range weapons because we have some proper buildings for cover. We can hide behind them, and we also have a rooftop here that are snipers.
I'm on it.
Snipers can use.
Yes.
So let's put Esper with his relatively long-range weapon up there, and Buns with her great marksmanship skill.
Yes. I'm on it.
Yes.
Let's have them here as lookouts.
Yes.
Yes.
Then we'll also want to set Barry and Ira in a position where they can keep an eye on things. But not too far, so that they can move to cover in or around this building. Rather not move Ira any further. I think this position where Barry is good enough to keep an eye on this road. And both also for any coming this northern side of the fence.
You got my ear.
I'd rather not move Ira this far away either. So it may be best if we'll just have her hide behind this car and pop out when the moment is right. Alright, we're in decent positions to intercept the enemy, so now while we wait for them to show up, we can start resting. If we're lucky, they may not even attack this location, but I think it's unlikely. Now we do have quite a bit of time available to us. I want to attack Drassen at night. I prefer to do all major offensives, particularly with towns and installations and or buildings in general at night. We'll get into why I prefer that once we get there. Let's worry about this patrol first. Yeah, it's approaching us. I think it's very likely that
we have company. Adriana's men are around.
That they are. Well, let's hope we'll have a chance to position ourselves.
Yes.
You got my ear.
Now we just
time
wait.
For the enemy to say its prayers.
Yeah, showing up right away. I think I want to take a shot at them, just to so that they know we're here, and they'll start moving towards us. Where we're in a better position to shoot at them. So I want to take a unaimed shot at the guy. Then let's move into cover.
Yes.
Once they'll likely start moving towards us, that's when we will pop these two characters out of cover.
Yes.
Do they have any sort of visibility here? They do have some visibility. It's not all red. That means the enemies can likely see us when they get close enough, but that's fine.
Yes. Horses are in hiding, but are still close.
We're back in the real-time mode.
Yes.
Take a quick peek. Well, they actually get smart. Where are they? Are they really not interested in attacking us?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, all right then. Ah, we have been joined.
They are keeping their distance, which is not what I want. Let's just start taking pot shots at him. Hope. Don't even have vision. Bunt still somehow managed to hit. That should get their attention if nothing else.
Yes.
Keep in mind, we didn't get them all. Yes.
These are the kinds of fights where I'm weakest at, by far.
You got my ear.
We have been joined.
Open air in the daylight. Not my strength at all. But luckily the enemies are very weak. These are the green-shirted enemies. Or I suppose that's yellow. They're the weakest tier of enemies, and yes, the ones that we will see only at the start of the game. Very good. Nice job, Bear. It was a difficult shot. You did it.
Yes. Yes.
There we go. This is an interrupt. This is something that I don't think we saw in the previous battle. Now, all mercenaries can interrupt enemies during their turn, and likewise, our enemies can interrupt us during our turn. This particularly happens, or I think it only happens when the character who does the interrupt is not visible to the enemy, but the enemy pops into their line of fire. I don't really know how to put it into words. I don't think that's a very good explanation. It also takes into account the character's experience level, which is another thing we haven't really talked about yet. More experienced characters are more likely to interrupt lower level characters.
Intruders.
Let's talk about it in more detail when we're not getting shot.
Yes.
Alright. This is starting to get very sticky. Barry in particular is in one of the difficult spots, so let's have her sprint over to the building.
Yes.
Also. Bones and Esper are also in pretty serious line of fire right now. Should we take a greedy shot? Perhaps. How much does it take to move into proper cover? Take anything from 9 to 9 points. This might still be somewhat visible to the enemies.
Yes.
Yeah, not happening. Perhaps I shouldn't have even done that. Yeah, we're still a bit visible. But hopefully less so. Dang it. Double dang it. I spent too many points. Okay, that's a bit better.
Yes.
Yeah.
Why, that was close enough to be invigorating.
Eesh.
Wonder how many lives I've got left after that.
Yeah. A lot of close calls. Got a bit lucky that I didn't get my ass shot off there.
Yes.
Let's move even further. Up the roof.
Yes.
I could still take a shot from here. May as well. Unlikely to hit anything, but give it a shot.
Yes.
Now what we can do is wait for them to come closer to us, and then Barry and Ira can hopefully take some.
You got my ear.
Yes.
Shots as well. In combat, you always want to reload your guns with full magazines. If I would have reloaded or used one of these ones that are not full, it would not have filled the ammo completely.
Cripes.
Yeah. Don't think this is gonna happen.
Yes.
Give him a couple of turns. See what they do.
Yes, keep in mind, we didn't get them all.
Trouble is here.
That's what we wanted. Still alive, huh? Oh shit.
You got my ear.
How far is that? I got a bit greedy there.
Yes.
I'll have to take this guy out with Bonzo.
Intruders.
Oh, there's another one there. That's excellent. Alright, Esper. It's up to you. Oof, the enemy's got an interrupt.
Yes, wonder how many lives I've got left after that.
Me too, man. Me too.
Enemy!
Oh shit, they keep getting interrupts on us. That's because Esper is only level 1. Let's put some burst fire on these guys. Well, they're both critical.
Yes.
Which is very low.
Yes.
But they're also so close to parry. They're still quite likely to get a shot. And Ira, of course, their low marksmanship is unlikely to hit anything anytime soon. Yeah, I got very greedy.
You got my ear.
I got very greedy last turn when I took the other shot with Barry instead of moving him into cover, and he got rewarded by getting shot.
Yes.
How did he? Yeah, think I'm just gonna stop. I don't wanna play this game anymore.
Yes.
That's more like it.
Groovy. Look there.
You got my ear.
Okay, so that's how many kills? 2, which means we still have 5 left. Oh.
It was close enough to be invigorating.
Lucky shot.
Yes.
Well, I suppose it's not that lucky now I think about it. That was lucky.
Yes.
Yes.
Let's pop back into cover.
Yes.
It's not perfect cover either, but very good. Starting to make up for those 2 misses last
time. Yes.
Anybody else moving in? Nope.
Cripes.
Yes.
So that's, so we have knowledge of 4 out of 7, 2 of them being dead.
Yes.
Yeah, let's not take shots just yet, we'll let them. This guy is critical. You see the above his name, he had the critical status, which means he's very low health and is currently bleeding to death. So I don't mind that if he decides to back out of the fight, he'll just bleed to death eventually. Enemies can't do first aid on themselves for some reason. Let's not forget to reload Barry's gun.
I'm sure we didn't find all of Deidreana's men.
You got my ear. I'm on it.
Yeah.
I'm on
somebody just bled to death.
Yes.
Let's see what we see.
Time for the enemy to say its prayers.
Yeah, they're
don't
just hanging out.
That one.
Yeah. We only currently have visibility on his head. Which means we can't even try to try at all. Well, we can try a torso shot. The character even mentioned that that's not about to happen anytime soon.
Yes.
I know I won't allow myself to be convinced they left the area.
Me neither.
Yes. You got my ear, Roger.
Yes.
You got my ear.
Let's see if we get any visibility on them.
The army. I knew we'd see them sooner or later.
It's once again so out of range. I'm not sure if it's even worth the bother. Trying to move too close would just leave Ira very open to being shot and her low marksmanship.
I'm on it.
Means there's no guarantee that she would be able to hit even in range.
Yes.
Guess what? Yeah, there's that problem with the torso shots. Yeah, good luck hitting a headshot out of range.
Why, that was close enough to be invigorating.
Alright, so the enemies have gotten a little bit wise to our tricks, which means we'll have to move out of here. Just gonna be stuck here all day.
Yes. I'm sure we didn't find all of Deidreana's men.
Which I would rather not do. That guy just bled to death.
Yes.
You got my ear, Roger.
Tell you what, Ira. Patch
the
up.
The army. I knew we'd see them sooner or later. I'm on it.
Know about that guy.
You got my ear.
We may not have a choice but to rush him. The amount of enemies still alive, there's three besides this one, makes me a little bit concerned about a rushing strategy. Yeah. Well,
yes, I'm on it.
I have to use Espe and his. Oops.
Yes.
Somebody
time
just saw us.
Time for the enemy to say its prayers.
Yeah. Maybe we should exit this roof in a safer position.
Yes.
Let's be smart for once.
Yes. Horses are in hiding, but are still close.
I'm on it. I'm on it.
Oops, I was a bit open.
I'm on it. Roger.
Yes. Time for the enemy to say its prayers. I hear ya.
Yeah, he sees us.
Yes.
Should have known that was gonna happen.
I hear ya.
No matter.
Yes.
You see, my friend, that yes. is not how you approach a situation like this. Good. Barry got some marksmanship. Let's see if Ira could pop in a lucky shot as well. Nope.
Yes.
No matter. Oh. I'm sorry.
Got a gun jam here.
Hello, darkness, my old friend. He's still alive.
Yes.
Yeah, that can, by the way, happen with guns that are in poor shape. They can occasionally jam up. Something I should have perhaps predicted as well. Thank God. I swear if that guy was gonna get a hit on me after all this.
Yes.
Probably just quit.
I'm sure we didn't find all of Deidreana's men.
The way you can unjam a gun is you can try to force fire it like this, and it unjammed it instantly. Takes into account the character's mechanical skill.
Yes.
Well, mechanically inclined ones are more likely to unjam it instantly. Got a bit lucky that we got it right away. What's next? So we still have three enemies to hunt down, which makes me extremely concerned. Whatever the case, I think we'll have to leave the safety of this roof,
yes.
and let's not leave our character open.
Yes.
Do have a bad habit of doing that sometimes. Could also be hiding out there in the wheat field.
Understood.
Yes. That's a possibility.
Yes.
Yes, I hear ya. I hear ya.
You yes. got my ear. I'm on it.
Well then, I think our next move would be to move towards this barn.
Yes, I'm
could
on
also
it.
Work as a decent bit of ear. Cover as well.
I'm on it.
Yes.
Let's not forget
you
to reload.
My ear.
Yes.
Let's regroup a little bit.
Yes.
Actually,
yes.
Barry Buns, go and check out this side. This does leave us a little bit open from this field in case someone happens to be camping
yes.
out there,
ear.
But take that risk.
Look there.
Yes.
yes. All right, then.
Yes.
You got my ear.
No one visible just yet. No one in the barn.
Time for the enemy to say its prayers.
Got the initiative.
Bad guys.
Yeah, that's the rest of them.
Yes.
Well, one more. But they're usually pretty close to each other. Cases like this. All right.
You got my ear.
It's a good thing that we encountered them here around the barn. Means we can use this barn as an effective cover, and also Buns and Barry can move in from here and flank these guys.
Yes.
Alright, so Esper, you with your long range weapon. Stick to around here.
You got my ear.
You did your best. That's all that matters. And Ira. Keep Ira around here as well. If the enemies get closer, she can move in and take shots.
Yes.
Still bit concerned about the third guy, where he's currently located. Let's move Barry and Bun slowly towards them.
Yes.
So they have, if they do get an interrupt, they'll have some action points left over. Interrupts always use the action points that you have left over from your turn.
Yes.
Cripes.
Good. He's standing up. He's just very unfortunately covered by the fence, so I can only see his head, but this guy does not have that luxury. Fence does protect him somewhat.
You got my ear.
Okay, let's move back a little bit.
Yes.
Oops. Didn't really work. Think we could turn off stealth mode. Oops.
Yes.
I was still in the same turn. So much for leaving the action points. Saw a shot coming from over here, which implies the third one is over there. It's good to know. That, by the way, is the power of hollow point ammo against unarmored targets. One hit, one kill.
Yes. Yes.
Yes.
You got my ear. Fudge.
Yeah, that's the third one. Leave enough AP to pop back into cover.
Yes.
Cripes.
Uh-oh. Interrupt. That's bad.
Yes.
Yikes. Okay. I think since the fact that they're getting interrupts so regularly means that... Yeah, I think we'll want to... move Barry and Buns into position as fast as we can. Now that we know all the positions, we can do it a little bit safer. Hop over the fence next turn. I don't want to do this popping in and out of cover, since they seem to get those interrupts with that kind of regularity. Ira is actually higher level than our main character, which is kind of funny.
Yes.
She'll have a lower chance of getting interrupted.
Understood.
Yes. Understand.
Move Buns and Barry from this side of the fence, since the enemy seems to be grouping
up
over here.
I'm sure we didn't find all of Deidreana's men.
Understood. Yes. Ah, we have been joined.
Kind of range. Fairly high range, but no matter. We may get lucky.
He's terrible.
Oh, I wish I had a grenade.
Yes.
Yes.
You got my ear.
Disappointing.
Okay.
You got my ear.
Yes.
Cripes.
One hit, one kill. That's in range, excellent. Buns actually has sight, which I don't know, when I'm looking at it doesn't make much sense. But that's good hits.
You got my ear.
What kind of range is it from here? 13 does, so Ira also has
a
in-range shot from here as well. Oh, but she doesn't see. Alright, that's because I SP shot this guy. Yeah, of course. How silly of me. Let's not take a risky shot just yet.
You got my ear!
Ira with the finishing blow. Yep, fantastic.
Once someone notifies their next of kin, we can move on to the next sector.
It wasn't perfect. It's not the best performance I've ever had, but could have been worse too. Took a bit of a damage, but very minor scrapes. Yes. Something we can very easily heal before we even hit Drassen.
Okay. Look there. Look there.
Oh, Desert Eagle. It's a nice gun.
Okay.
Nice gun for a pistol, that okay. is. All, just about all handguns get.
Understand.
Yes.
Get out of favor.
You got my ear.
Yes. Okay.
Check the inventories just in case we find something. One other reason why there. I want to. Oh, a Colt 45. That's also a pretty solid gun. One other reason why I like to avoid these early patrols is that the enemy drops just are not that great. Typically. We did find that MP53 in the first fight, which was a very lucky break. Do a quick bit of inventory management. Now sadly, since this gun is in enemy weapons early on are pretty in a pretty crappy shape, which affects their accuracy, which is why I don't want to switch into them instantly. But I will want to take them along for the ride. Actually, Barry, share a bit of your, what are these, 38s revolver ammo. Nine mils, that's for you, Bunce. You can combine items. I'm not sure if I showed this already, but if you have a lot of these partially filled clips, you can take a full clip, hold down control, and it combines the items together, like so. Handy for item management. 357s, and that's about it. Now, the good thing about that fight was that now we can rest before we hit Drassen in peace. Let's drop a quick save here, just in case we misclick or do something like that. Okay, so most of our damage is very small scratches, like 10% of maximum health. The characters do have natural healing over time, which smaller injuries in particular heal naturally quite fast, but major injuries will pretty much always require some sort of doctoring to get them healed up properly. So I think what we'll do is we'll have Buns doctor herself for a bit and for a few hours, and then we'll just get everyone to sleep. Characters, how wounded or tired characters are, also affect their effectiveness with different tasks in the game. This is represented by this number next to their portrait when they're doing a task. So now, as we can see, this is the current effectiveness / maximum potential effectiveness. So if Buns was at max energy and at max health, she would be healing worth of 20 points. I'm not exactly sure what this means. Is it 20 points per hour or something like that? But more is better with these numbers in general. So she's not quite at the maximum potential just yet, but that is fine. Barry, that is such a small wound, may not even necessarily need to. We'll set them as patients for a bit. So now, sadly, since we only have one medkit in our whole team, which means Buns has to spread her skills around a little bit. But with small injuries like this, we'll just need to heal them for a few points and then let natural healing deal with the rest. Luckily, we're gonna find several more medkits in Drassen, so we'll be able to heal more effectively, like Ira and Espe can both do some basic healing as well. But let's just start compressing time for a bit. For a few hours, we'll want to set Buns to sleep soon.
I'm finished here.
Yeah, all right. Very good. And Barry. Yeah, because the Buns' doctoring skill have to be spread up between so many characters, the healing is not very effective, so let's just turn Barry. Barry into idling and let him sleep. Sleeping doubles the natural healing rate. But of course, characters can't sleep all the time, only when their energy is depleted. Action is starting to get close to nightfall, so we'll let Buns sleep as well. Let's see. Nighttime lasts from 9 p.m. to around 7 a.m, so we don't have to attack just yet. We do still have some time to sleep before that. Let's watch the energy go up. That's pretty good. We don't necessarily have to be at max energy, but if we have the chance to get there, we'll want to do it. Everyone else is just about fully rested. Right out. Characters do spend a little bit of energy when idling as well. Something to keep in mind if you want to reach maximum energy. Right, I think we have a couple of hours time. One thing to note when making these attack plans is that it always takes some time to move into the sector as well. We can see in the bottom of this map, there's the ETA, or estimated time of arrival is 1.5 hours. So it takes a little while to get there. I think we can rest for an hour. Hour at least, maybe 2. Drassen is quite, it's the easiest town to take in this game, so I'm quite confident that we can do it in a single night. Just want to blitz through the whole thing. Alright. Yeah, that's about as good as we can make it. Well, but that's, whoa, we're already at 40 minutes. Now, I think that's it for one episode. So, in the next episode we'll be attacking Drassen and hopefully taking the holding in a single efficient attack. But that will be for the next one. So thanks for watching and see you in the next episode.